What's happening, guys? It's Jake McCarthy here, and I'm with David Kenny Farrell, yay! And today we're going to be showing you how to be an Éireannach. Who better to do it than a person from Leinster and from Munster? I'm from Youghal, County Cork. He's from
Wexford.
He's from Wexford. Ted Bundy of the West, Kenny. Step one, how to be Irish. You've got to hate
Endy Kenny.
You've got to be able to do your Irish phrases. Top of the morning to you is probably the most stereotypical fucking Irish thing you've ever
Going
said.
Going to Éireann an Bathair Tré.
What's that say?
Going to Éireann an Bathair Tré.
Ah, Jesus, be happy out. When you come to Ireland, here's the phrase you need to know. Diaguit, Sláinte go fóin, Pog Mahon. Nilain tin 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 was, man!
I think the Gardaí are run by the parish.
Well, you see, the thing is, there are two different types of guards in this country. The sound out ones and the ones who think they're in Detroit.
Yeah, they think they're from America, like.
No, I'm on a Sarge, and then there's the sound out ones who pretty much gets minimum wage, has a wife he's not really happy about, has four children who are already druggies, so...
He doesn't care.
He's kind of happy with himself.
He'll pull you over, but...
He'll pull you over
for a conversation, not the rest of your life. That's it.
Oh, jeez, I know Brian or something. But anyway, Pat, have you been drinking?
Jesus, what time is it now?
It's 2 a.m. in the morning.
I was drinking last night. I was drinking and...
And he'd walk away and probably steal your fags or something. Tea. A cup of tea. If you're going to Ireland, you need like tea. Even if you're allergic to tea...
You need to try drink it.
Yeah, try and drink it. If you don't like tea, if you don't like the idea of tea, then you don't drink it.
In some households, coffee is acceptable.
Coffee is acceptable. We love our coffee, but we love our tea more.
Everyone loves tea in Ireland, and if you don't, because they're usually from somewhere else.
You must be Protestant or something.
Yeah, you're foreign. Now, in other countries, you have unleaded, which is petrol. Over here, it's petrol. No, it isn't, right? It's petrol. But diesel. We don't say diesel, we say diesel.
Diesel!
Now we're sucking diesel.
Okay, Irish slang for you guys. We're gonna say a few words in Irish old slang phrases. Gobshite.
Egypt. Manky.
I'm only codding you.
Haggle away at yourself.
Go fuck yourself.
Feck off.
Fucking monarchy.
Up the parish.
Yeah, she's a fucking ride. So we charm the knickers off a nun. Alcohol. No alcohol. Alcohol in this country now is very important to us. Not just because we love the old drink, but it's the only thing we really had back in the old famine times. You know what I mean?
It's the only thing you really have nowadays.
Yeah, pretty much. We had that in the potato.
I think Ireland's the only country where alcohol fixes problems.
See, we drink so much, we have like different stages for being drunk. You have relaxed, legless, pissed, scuttered, mouldy, fucked, ossified.
Ossified. And then you're...
You're fucking Gio. You're fucking gone. Roofinator.
At the point where you're gone, there's no hope of turning back. Might as well keep drinking because it might only get worse.
And in a place down here in Cork, we say langers.
You Mickey!
Okay, if you're coming to Ireland, you gotta bring your fucking portable charger, you gotta bring your own fucking water because we don't have that. Nobody wants to pay for it. You have to bring your own wife because you're not gonna find anything because they're all taken by the Polish people. You have to find your own job in a different country because you're not going to get any jobs here because they're taken by the Turkish, beating down the Turks. You're fucking hell.
Oh yeah, this is a multilingual place.
Country is such a small country, there's only 4.5 million people in this country, but it's so beyond diverse, it's actually scary. If you come to Ireland, you're going to be witnessed by four different parts of this country. You're going to find the Cork area, the Dublin area, the Galway area, and Kerry. Now Kerry itself is its own country to us now, to be honest. It's the
Kerry
only
is foreign. You say I'm going to Kerry, go I'm going foreign.
Jesus.
They have their own language by this stage. I'm not messing.
I'm not messing.
And you'd be like, Tommy, give me the camera.
Quick, we found a new species.
George Bernard Shaw actually once said that Ireland is the only open air asylum in all of Western Europe. It means we're all fucked.
The Irish love the dig holes.
Even if you're a 4-year-old boy and his name is Tomas, you're going to love to dig holes. It's like, Mammy, can I dig a hole,
Okay, I'll get your buckets and spade. No, give me the big shovel over there.
Now, even when you were a child, you were given a spoon. Start digging holes. You go to the beach in Ireland, holes everywhere.
You don't even have to pay a person to fucking dig a hole.
No, let's do it. How
they'd be happily out of it, just to dig your holes, you know.
Why do you think there's so much holes in the middle of the road?
And how?
Council, they say that it'd be a sin to fill these holes.
The county councils are a bunch of bastards that make us dig holes. If World War III was commenced tomorrow, there's three different ways how people would act things. A French man would have sex with his wife and then kill himself. An American person would go to the tallest building of the city and...
Another person would go to Spain for 2 weeks and hope it all blow over by the time he got back.
Is it done? No, I'm going back to Malaga. Take the piss out of things, like a funeral. We'd all fucking laugh at a funeral. Mickey Doyle. He was a great man. What are you laughing at? My brother.
Still said Mickey.
Now I suppose this is a bit funny, isn't it? Even the fucking priest would be like, ha ha ha, so funny. Of course the fucking priest had to be English.
Your humour and your racism.
Here's the one thing that I will never say, that I will never, ever, ever, ever regret. Being born an Irish person.
No, I would never regret it.
Being Irish is just...
It's an excuse to do what you want.
It's privilege and it's pride.
You have to laugh constantly. And you have to dig a hole. I think I might go dig a hole in about 5 minutes.
Good stuff.
You're going in it.
I'll see you later, Dave. Go fucking dig my hole.
Alright, see you.
See you later, lads.